Hello everyone, today we will discuss about vitamin B7 or biotin. It is a water soluble vitamin. Synonyms are bios, then vitamin H, coenzyme R, then anti egg white injury factor. Anti egg white injury factor. This is the structure of vitamin B7. This biotin is a heterocyclic monocarboxylic acid. It is a sulfur containing water soluble B vitamin. The structure consists of two fused rings. We can see two fused rings here. This is imidazole ring, and here it is thiophene derivative. Imidazole ring and thiophene derivative. Biotin is chemically hexahydro 2 oxo 1 thieno 3 4 imidazole 4 valeric acid. It can be represented as C10H16O3N5S. It's a sulfur containing water soluble B vitamin. There are two forms of vitamin B7 are there. They are alpha biotin and beta biotin. Alpha and beta. Alpha in egg yolk and beta is in liver. This both differs only in the nature of side chain. Then biotin occurs as free form and in bound form. Free form and bound form. Bound forms include biocytin, desthiobiotin and oxybiotin. Biocytin, then desthiobiotin and oxybiotin. These are the bound forms of this biotin. Biocytin is epsilon N biotinyl lysine. Epsilon N biotinyl lysine. In this, biotin bound with lysine residues. Biotin bound with lysine residues of tissue proteins by amide bonds. That is biocytin. Next one is desthiobiotin and oxybiotin. These are biologically active in certain strains of yeast and bacteria. These are the bound forms. Coming to biosynthesis, this biotin can be synthesized by many bacteria, yeast and fungi and higher plants. Then metabolism, it can be stored in the liver and kidneys. Coming to excretion, it is excreted in urine, feces and milk. Normal adults on an adequate diet excretes 10 to 180 mu gram daily in urine and 15 to 200 mu gram daily in feces. Fecal excretion represents unabsorbed biotin synthesized by the intestinal bacteria. These are the unabsorbed biotins. Next, we will see food sources. It is widely distributed in plant and animal tissues. It occurs as water soluble forms in most plant materials. Except cereals and nuts. Then it exists as water insoluble form in animal tissues. Then foods rich in biotin include, animal sources are liver, kidney, milk products and egg yolk. Then vegetable sources include legumes, all vegetables, grains and molasses. Large doses or this higher content is seen in royal jelly. This is the richest source of vitamin B7. then human beings cannot synthesize the vitamin, and so it has to be supplied by the diet. The intestinal bacterial flora can also synthesize the vitamin. That is a source of vitamin B7 in humans from dietary source and from intestinal bacterial synthesis. Next, we will see metabolic roles. Coming to metabolic roles, biotin is the prosthetic group of certain enzymes that catalyze carbon dioxide transfer reaction or carbon dioxide fixation reaction. So they act as they are the prosthetic group of certain enzymes that catalyze carbon dioxide transfer reaction or carbon dioxide fixation reaction. Biotin functions as the coenzyme for the enzymes carboxylases. Act as coenzyme for the enzyme carboxylases, which catalyzes the carbon dioxide fixation reaction. In this process, biotin is first converted to carboxybiotin complex or carbon dioxide biotin complex. Carbon dioxide biotin complex. We'll see the structure. Carbon dioxide biotin complex. C double bond O, NH, lysine protein. So this is the structure of carbon dioxide biotin complex. In this process, biotin is first converted to carboxybiotin complex by reaction with bicarbonate and ATP. This carbon dioxide biotin complex is the source of active carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide biotin complex is the source of active carbon dioxide, which is transferred to the substrate. Next, we will see examples of this carbon dioxide fixation reaction in biological system. Carbon dioxide fixation reaction in biological system. First one is conversion of acetyl-CoA to malonyl-CoA. That is CH3C double bond OSCOA. This is acetyl-CoA. It is converted to malonyl-CoA. That is CH2COOH. Here C double bond OSCOA. This is malonyl-CoA. Here acetyl-CoA carboxylase is the enzyme. Here one carbon dioxide with the help of biotin. ATP, ADP plus PI. One MN2+. So carbon dioxide fixation reaction in biological system, first example is conversion of acetyl-CoA to malonyl-CoA. In the first step of extra mitochondrial de novo fatty acid synthesis, acetyl-CoA is converted to malonyl-CoA. The reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase. That is the first example. Next one is conversion of propionyl-CoA to methylmalonyl-CoA. That is CH3CH2COSCOA. That is propionyl-CoA. Propionyl-CoA is converted to methylmalonyl-CoA. That is CH3CH COOH COSCOA, methyl malonyl methyl malonyl CoA. Here the enzyme is propionyl CoA carboxylase. Carboxylase enzyme. Here carbon dioxide, biotin, same reaction ATP, ADP plus PI. This is MN plus plus. So conversion of propionyl CoA to malonyl CoA by the enzyme propionyl CoA carboxylase. This is another example of carbon dioxide fixation reaction. Next example is conversion of pyruvate to oxaloacetate. Pyruvate to oxaloacetate, that is CH3C double bond O COOH. That is pyruvate, it is converted to oxaloacetate, that is COOH CH2C double bond O, then COOH. This is oxaloacetate. By the enzyme pyruvate carboxylase. Pyruvate carboxylase, here carbon dioxide, biotin, then ATP, ADP plus PI, MN plus plus. So the enzyme catalyzing the reaction is pyruvate carboxylase. Pyruvate is converted to oxaloacetate. This is another example of carbon dioxide fixation reaction in biological system. Then other reactions where biotin included are conversion of methyl beta methyl crotonyl CoA. Beta methyl crotonyl CoA to beta methyl glutaconyl CoA. Here also biotin is involved. Reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme beta methyl crotonyl CoA carboxylase. Carboxylase enzyme beta methyl crotonyl CoA to beta methyl glutaconyl CoA. This is in leucine metabolism. Here also vitamin B7 or biotin included. Then other enzyme systems include succinic acid dehydrogenase and decarboxylase. Then deaminases of amino acids, aspartic acid, serine and threonine. Next we will see deficiency manifestations. Deficiency manifestations. Biotin deficiency is induced in experimental animals. This is by inclusion of large amounts of raw egg white in the diet. Inclusion of large amounts of raw egg white. Then by using sulfonamide drugs or broad spectrum oral antibiotics for prolonged periods. Then deficiency features include dermatitis, spectacle eyed appearance due to circumocular alopecia. Then thinning or loss of hairs, graying of hair, paralysis of hind legs. These are the features in deficiency. In humans, deficiency causes dermatitis of the extremities, pallor of skin and mucous membrane, then anorexia, nausea, muscle pain, depression, anemia and hypercholesterolemia. Two conditions are related to biotin deficiency. Two conditions. First one is, that is congenital and acquired. First one is congenital. Congenital conditions. A rare genetic deficiency of holocarboxylase synthase. This genetic deficiency, this enzyme helps to utilize biotin in metabolic rod. The affected child cannot utilize biotin and develops biotin deficiency. This include dermatitis, graying of hair, alopecia, incoordination of movements. Then urine shows high urinary lactate, beta hydroxypropionate and beta methyl crotonate. This is due to the failure of enzyme activities. That is congenital, then acquired. Also known as Leiner's disease. Leiner's disease. Other names are erythroderma desquamativum or exfoliative dermatitis. It is seen in breastfed infants in association with persistent diarrhea. The low biotin content of human milk together with the poor absorption of biotin due to diarrhea cause the vitamin B7 deficiency. Administration of biotin causes a cure in these diseases. Next, we will see daily requirement. Daily requirement in adults, it's about 25 to 50 μg daily. In infants, it is 10 to 15 μg daily. In children, it is about 20 to 40 μg daily. Then this requirement increases in pregnancy and in lactation. Then oral antibiotic therapy for prolonged periods. So these are the daily requirements. This is about vitamin B7. This is today's topic. Thank you for watching.